The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to bring good tidings to the afflicted. This morning is 714. Service tonight, and our young people that are we're going through the confirmation program. They are being confirmed. We had a wonderful time these past 2 years, and one of the young people said, "Reverend Trevors, I'm going to be an old man the time I leave youth group." So I said, "That's wonderful." I said, "You certainly can be a part of youth group forever." I said, "Be a server as well." So I'm looking forward to seeing what God is going to do with these young people. I want to say thank you to those who came out and participated in our flash mob. At last count, we had over 12,000 views on YouTube. It was awesome. And it was just one of those wonderful evenings, and it was so great to see so many people come out, and some people might be thinking, what's a flash mob? What we did is in the middle of the midst of the busy Christmas season, a bunch of us showed up at the mall, and I started at one end, and Dave and I went down to one end, started heaving out jingle bells, and drew everybody in and out of the stores. Then we got up to where Santa usually sits and greets the children, and we sang some Christmas carols there, and even Mary and Joseph and baby Jesus came and showed up. It was so awesome. It was really, really awesome. So I just want to commend that to you. If you haven't seen it, we're on your church website and on the church's Facebook. It's there. So you're welcome to take a look at that. Can I have the children please come forward? Good morning, honey. How are you this morning?
Stay right there.
Don't move.
Testing.
Scoot over. Oh, I see.
Okay, that's totally fine. I don't blame you at all.
What a smart young man. All right, could I have the bag, please? Now,
oh my goodness, there's nothing in the bag.
I know. Say that again. What's in the bag? I don't know. Okay, let's see. Let's see what's in the bag.
My brother a try.
Okay. What's this?
Elf?
No. All right. What is?
Hee-haw.
Yeah, absolutely. I love Mom's translation. I like this. This is awesome. Interpretation of stuff. Oh, can I have one? May as well give me the pants. Yes, that's fine. Can I have the horsey? Thank you. Okay, we have a horsey this morning here. And how many of you have ridden a horse? How many of you have owned your own horse? How many had a horse named George? How many had a horse that when you whistled to it, when it was in the field, and it would come?
No.
I had a horse named George. And my daughter's going out with a boy named George. I can't wait to meet him because I want to whistle just to see him. Okay, so if we were going to use a horsey to tell people about Jesus, how would we use a horsey to tell people about Jesus?
Because Jesus made all animals.
That is awesome. That's wonderful. That's exactly it. He made them all, and he made them all for us to enjoy. And you know what? I particularly enjoy.
We can ride for God.
We can ride for God. Okay, I like that too. Okay, you can hold that now for a second. Don't go away though. You gotta stay here. What is there anything else that we could use the horsey for to tell people about Jesus? Is there anything else, or does that kind of cover it? We could ride for God. Jesus creates all the, he made all the animals, including the horses. I like that.
I have to make all the animals.
We can always tell people about God and about His goodness and about how much He loves us. Wonderful. Thank you, boys and girls. Just 1 second now. Would you put your hands up? 1, 2, 3. Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
Thank you for today.
For all our fun,
at work and play.
At work and play.
Thank you for your creation.
Thank you for your creation.
It is beautiful.
It is beautiful.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, boys and girls, stay right here because we're going to have the lighting of the Advent wreath and we're going to sing our song. Okay, stand up, boys and girls.
The past 2 Sundays, we have lit the candles of hope and peace. We light them again to remind us that Christ will come again and to fulfill all of God's promises to us.
Today we light the candle of joy to remind us that Jesus is the one who brings true and everlasting joy.
Joy and hope is the promise of new life.
Let us pray.
God of joy, in the darkness of suffering and loss, your prophet soul, the light coming into the world, may we proclaim that light of Christ as we stand alongside migrants, refugees, and all who have no homes, so they may find new strength and joy.
Okay, boys and girls, turn this way, and we're going to sing that Jesus was born in Bethlehem. Jesus was born in Bethlehem. Jesus was born in my heart. Jesus was born in Bethlehem. Jesus was born in my heart. Christmas is joy. Jesus is joy. The King was born in Bethlehem. Christmas was joy. Joy, the King was born in my heart. Thank you, boys and girls. Can you grab one of the staffs? And okay, John, can you grab one of the staffs too? And Sunday school, you may go down. Stand with me. When God's anointed one comes,
the desert will rejoice and flowers will bloom in the wasteland.
When God's anointed one comes,
our hands will receive new strength and fearful ones will find fresh courage.
When God's anointed one comes,
the lame will lead and dance, the blind will see.
When God's anointed one comes,
through grieving and sorrow, you will be forever free.
God of power and mercy, you call us once again to celebrate the coming of your Son.
Remove those things which hinder love of you, and when he comes, you may find us waiting in awe and wonder for him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit,
one God,
now and forever.
Amen. Please be seated for the proclamation of our word.
Mommy. The first reading this morning is from Isaiah 35, verses 1 to 10. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad, the desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus shall blossom abundantly, and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, and the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord and the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of fearful heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God. He will come with vengeance, with terrible recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. For water shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water. The haunt of jackals shall become a swamp. The grass shall become reeds and rushes. A highway shall be there, and it shall be called the Holy Way. The unclean shall not travel on it, but it shall be for God's people. No traveler, not even fools, shall go astray. No lion shall be there, nor shall any ravaged beast come upon it. They shall not be found there, but the reins shall walk there. And the ransom of the Lord shall return, come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy be upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. Word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Instead of a psalm this morning, we have Canticle 18a, found on page 86. Page 86. The Song of Mary. I'm going to ask that we just read this totally all together as one, the whole works this morning. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He has come to help his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from James, chapter 5, verses 7 to 10. Be patient, therefore, beloved, until the coming of the Lord. The farmer waits for the precious crop from the earth, being patient with it until it receives the early and the late rains. You also must be patient. Strengthen your hearts, for the coming of the Lord is near. Beloved, do not grumble against one another, so that you may not be judged. See, the judge is standing at the doors. As an example of suffering and patience, beloved, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gradual hymn is 62.
Thank you. Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. When John heard in prison what the Messiah was doing, he sent word by his disciples and said to him, "Are you the one who is to come, or are we to wait for another?" Jesus answered them, "Go and tell John what you hear and see. The blind receive their sight, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the poor have good news brought to them. And blessed is anyone who takes no offense at me." As they went away, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. "What did you go out into the wilderness to look at? A reed shaken by the wind? What then did you go out to see? Someone dressed in soft robes? Look, those who wear soft robes are in royal palaces. What then did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, 'See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you.' Truly I tell you, among those born of women, no one has arisen greater than John the Baptist, yet the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he." The Gospel of Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us pray. God is already here. Can't you feel his presence? He's already here. All we have to do is open up our hearts, for he is already here. Amen. Please be seated. First of all, I got to tell you, I want to tell you two stories this morning. One's my story. I was getting ready for Sunday, and I always print off the scriptures early in the week, and Tuesday just happened to be one of those days during the day that you're so busy, and things are going the opposite of right. Does anybody know what that is? Have you ever lived in those moments where they're going the opposite of right? And I want you to know that it was going, I want to say this word, and I say it with humble adoration for those who go through these every once in a while, like yourselves and me, is I was having a day that was going all wrong. So anyway, so in the afternoon, I finally got home. I said, "Now I'm going to print out the scriptures. I want to read the scriptures." And so I printed off the scriptures, and I opened up my James reading, and it said this: "Be patient, therefore." I lifted up my head, and I'm thinking, you know, do I have to be the butt of all your jokes? Oh, I love it when God plays jokes on me and brings me to new understandings. And patience is one of those things that I'm coming to a new understanding about. That I used to never ask for it, but now I'm beginning to see the gift of patience and what it really is. But I don't want to talk about James. I want to talk about our gospel reading, and I want to begin with a story. It's not my story. It was from a minister when I was growing up, and he spoke about when he would he was called into the hospital to perform last rites, and when he had got there, he had heard the story. Good morning. He had heard the story, and it was a good friend of his who had happened to have been a minister as well, and he had kept saying for the past 3 days, "Just one more. Just one more. That had been the phrase that had been just repeating over and over like a record on skip. Just one more. You see, he had been a great evangelist, and he had won people to Christ all his life, and he had brought people up in the faith, and he had seen tremendous things happen, and God had performed mighty acts through the ministry that he had done all his life. And when he had got to the end, the only phrase that would keep coming out of his mouth is just one more. His daughter was there, and the nurse was wondering why he was saying just one more. I used this story a few weeks ago in our evening service. And the daughter began to explain about who her father was and what he had done, and the message of hope that he had been sharing with others all his life. And you know, that created questions in her, and she began to ask more questions and more questions, and there was curiosity that was being created in this young lady's heart, and eventually the daughter of this man who was passing away invited this nurse to accept Christ, and she did. And within a day, the man who had been saying just one more had passed away, because one more made it in. I like that story, and I'm going to bring that into our gospel reading, because I love our gospel, because this gospel is such a powerful gospel. John is in prison, and prison in those days was not a pretty sight. There was no rights. There was absolutely no rights. He was in prison and in big trouble. Talk about a day going wrong. John was having one of those days, and so he had been hearing about this Jesus. He had been hearing about this Jesus and what this Jesus was doing. And so he sent his disciples to go and ask him. And he got there, they got to Jesus, and they said, "Listen, John sent us, and he wants to know." And I love this. He wants to know. You know, I can hear the authority in their voices as they want. John wants to know. John wants to know. Are you the one? Or are we to wait for another? Are you the Messiah? Or are we to wait for another? You see, Jesus wasn't the only one. Ooh, you bring me a snack? Jesus wasn't the only one claiming at the time to be the Messiah. And they wanted to know. They wanted to know if he was the one, not just a one. You understand? There's a big difference in those little phrasing. The one, there is no other. Gonna come up? Okay. You know, there is a big difference between being A and being the. Being A is one of many. Being the, there is no other. There is no other. And they said, Jesus turned to them, "Go back and tell John this. What you hear and what you see. Go back and take John the evidence of your own experience. What are you hearing? What are you seeing? What is the experience that you're having?" And that was going to, I can remember when we'd be doing work in the fields or back in the woods getting wood. You're going to go to mom? Okay. There we go. Dad would say, "This here is going to separate the men from the boys." And you know what? By the evidence that they were going to take back of what they were hearing and seeing was going to separate the A and the. the A,
B,
and V. And he said, go back and tell them what you're seeing. The blind is receiving sight, the lame walk. The good news is being preached to the poor. The dead are being raised. Good stuff is taking place and you can see it. And not only did they see it, they experienced for themselves. So when they took back the message to John, they weren't just taking back, yeah, he's one of them. He's one of them. But he is the Christ, was the message that they were going to be able to take back. And the message of what they were going to see and hear and experience would affirm in John's life that this was the one whom Isaiah spoke about. And Jesus read the scriptures in his first sermon, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach good news to the captive, set the captive free, the lame to walk, the blind to see, the dead shall raise, and the good news shall be preached, and that I will declare the year of the Lord's favor." And that would affirm in John, that's the one. Because you know what? There was no other reports coming back on any others. The dead weren't being raised. The blind weren't being given their sight. The lame weren't jumping up and walking. And so this report on this Jesus, and actually I just want to point this out, it was his cousin. You hear what I'm saying? It was his cousin. He still wanted to know if he was the one. The one. And you know, folks, today, here we are, thousands of years later, and folks are still wondering, is he a God? Or is he the God? And I want you to know there is evidence in our scriptures all over the place. Jesus proclaimed himself, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes unto the Father except through me." You know, there is real evidence in the lives of people. We can still see and we can still hear about the real truth. The real truth. That nurse in the hospital that day, as she came in and heard this man saying, just one more, was a seeker of real truth. She didn't want something phony again. She wanted something absolutely truth. And she found it in the faith in Jesus Christ. And when one more had come, there it is. It was able to release him. To be taken up. And she was received with open arms. Because that's the Jesus that we serve. That's the Jesus that we love. He receives us just like I received this little fellow. Comes running with his arms up. I scoop him up. That's just like you and me. All he says is come. And he invites us to come. To run towards him with all our hearts. And I can almost hear the words. Just one more. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, our hearts are yearning this morning. This season is so busy and sometimes we can get so distracted. Father, as that epistle says, be patient therefore. Father, give us your patience. And Father, may we experience something that is truly profound as we listen. As we listen in the stillness and hear you speak into our hearts how much you love us. So come into our hearts, Lord Jesus. Come into our hearts to stay. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come into my heart and stay. Amen. Thank you for helping me this morning. That was wonderful. You just got God timing, I'm telling you. It's wonderful. I love it when God works out the little details, don't you? I just love it when God works out the little details. And our little people are so important to our church. Praise be to God. Folks, let us stand together, shall we? Let us stand together and for the affirmation of the faith, let us confess the faith of our baptism as we say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary.
He suffered under Pontius Pilate,
was crucified, died, and was buried.
He ascended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated for the prayers of the people.
The prayers this morning will be based on the Litany for Advent, number 12 on page 119. In joyful expectation, let us pray to our Savior and Redeemer, saying, Lord Jesus, come soon.
Lord Jesus, come soon.
In the tridiocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for the Diocese of Eastern Newfoundland Synod Office staff, the Right Reverend Dr. Jeffrey Peddle, the Venerable Sandra Tilley, the Venerable Sean Sampson, Miss Elizabeth Crisby, Mrs. Gail Britton, Mr. Darren Goss, Mr. Fred Dinham, and all retired clergy. In the Anglican cycle of prayer worldwide, we pray for the Diocese of Kiriko, Kenya, vacant right now of a bishop. So we pray that, Lord God, a bishop will be chosen for that diocese very soon. We also take time now to pray for those who are on our sick list. And we pray, Lord, for Melvie, for Larry and Jenny, Carl, Patsy, Joshua, Eileen, Rita, Matt, Debbie, Harvey, Adam, Florence, David, Lucy, Rose, Nettie, Mary and Lloyd, Ella, Wes, Blaine, Anne, Leroy, and Yvonne. Bless each one, Lord. Meet them at their point of need and heal them according to your will. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. O wisdom from the mouth of the Most High, you reign over all things to the ends of the earth. Come and teach us how to live.
Lord Jesus, come soon.
O Lord and head of the house of Israel, you appeared to Moses in the fire of the burning bush, and you gave the law on Sinai. Come with outstretched arm and ransom us.
Lord Jesus, come soon.
O branch of Jesse, standing as a sign among the nations, all kings will keep silence before you, and all peoples will summon you to their aid. Come, set us free, and delay no more.
Lord Jesus, come soon.
O key of David and scepter of the house of Israel, you open and none can shut. You shut and none can open. Come and free the captives from prison.
Lord Jesus, come soon.
O morning star, splendor of the light eternal and bright sun of righteousness, come and enlighten all who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death.
Lord Jesus, come soon.
O King of the nations, you alone can fulfill their desires. Cornerstone, you make opposing nations one. Come, O Lord, where Satan roams the earth, seeking whom he may devour. Come and rescue all those who are living in war-torn fear and circumstance. Come and fill all hearts with your holy fire, your holy love, your holy peace, and your holy joy. Come and save the creature you fashioned from clay.
Lord Jesus, come soon.
O Emmanuel, hope of the nations and their Savior, come and save us, Lord our God.
Lord Jesus, come soon.
Amen.
Page 191. Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love, infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners, and he invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Would you please stand with me? The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Would you share the peace of Christ with those around you?
Jesus, shall we wait?
God of hope, renew in us the joy of your salvation. Make us living sacrifice to you for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We give you thanks and praise, Almighty God, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer. He is your living Word, through whom you have created all things. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh of the Virgin Mary and shared our human nature. He lived and died as one of us to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. In fulfillment of your will, he stretched out his hands in suffering to bring a release to those who place their hope in you, and so he won for you a holy people. He chose to bear our griefs and sorrows and to give up his life on the cross, that he might shatter the chains of evil and death and banish the darkness of sin and despair. By his resurrection, he brings us into the light of your presence. Now with all creation, we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please be seated. Holy and gracious God, accept our praise through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on the night that he was handed over to suffering and death took bread, gave thanks, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body which is broken for you." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This is my blood which is shed for you. When you do this, you do it in memory of me." Remembering, therefore, his death and resurrection, we offer you this bread and this cup, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to be in your presence and serve you. We ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your holy church. Gather into one all who share in these sacred mysteries, filling them with the Holy Spirit, confirming their faith in the truth, that together we may praise you and give you glory through your servant, Jesus Christ. All glory and honor are yours, Father and Son, with the Holy Spirit and the Holy Church, now and forever.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God of promise, you prepare a banquet for us in your kingdom.
And there are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
The gifts of God are given for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. prayer after communion is found in our bulletin on the back. Merciful God, may this Eucharist free us from our sins, fill us with unending joy, prepare us for the very day of our Savior. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, who is the Lord now and forever. Amen. Now may the peace of God that passes all human understanding keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you, remain with you always, and those whom you love forevermore. Amen. Our closing hymn today is hymn number 67.
Our service begins.
Who's out there?